leader, the leader. We're following the leader wherever he may go.
Welcome to our service this Sunday from the Chet Valley Churches. And wherever you are, we hope that you will join with us in our worship. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Grace, mercy, and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Our first hymn is, Dear Lord and Father of Mankind. The grace of God has dawned upon the world through our Saviour Jesus Christ, who sacrificed himself for us to purify a people as his own.
Most merciful God, Father of our Lord Jesus Christ,
we confess that we have sinned in thought, word and deed. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbour as ourselves. In your mercy, forgive what we have been. Help us to amend what we are and direct what we shall be, that we may do justly, love mercy, and walk humbly with you, our God. Amen. May the God of all healing and forgiveness draw us to himself and cleanse us from all our sins, that we may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And so now we give glory to God as we say together the words of the Gloria. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to his people on earth. Lord God, heavenly King, almighty God and Father, we worship you, we give you thanks, we praise you for your glory. Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, Lord God, Lamb of God, you take away the sin of the world. Have mercy on us. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Receive our prayer. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. Let us pray the prayer for this day. Eternal Lord, our beginning and our end, bring us with the whole creation to your glory, hidden through the past ages and made known in Jesus Christ. Amen. And so we listen to our reading from the Old Testament.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. There will be no gloom for those who were in anguish. In the former time, he brought into contempt the land of Zebulun and the land of Naphtali. But in the latter time, he will make glorious the way of the sea, the land beyond the Jordan, Galilee of the nations. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in a land of deep darkness, on them has light shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy. They rejoice before you as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For the word of the Lord, thanks be to God.
Depend on you. Alleluia, alleluia. Christ was revealed in flesh, proclaimed among the nations, and believed throughout the world. Alleluia. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. Now when Jesus heard that John had been arrested, he withdrew to Galilee. He left Nazareth and made his home in Capernaum by the lake, in the territory of Zebulun and Naphtali, so that what had been spoken through the prophet Isaiah might be fulfilled. Land of Zebulun, land of Naphtali, on the road by the sea, across the Jordan, Galilee of the Gentiles. The people who sat in darkness have seen a great light. And those who sat in the region and the shadow of death, light has dawned. From that time, Jesus began to proclaim, "Repent, for the kingdom of heaven has come near." As he walked by the Sea of Galilee, he saw two brothers, Simon, who is called Peter, and Andrew, his brother, casting a net into the lake, for they were fishermen. And he said to them, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." Immediately they left their nets and followed him. As he went from there, he saw two other brothers, James, son of Zebedee, and his brother John, in the boat with their father Zebedee, mending their nets, and he called them. Immediately they left the boat and their father and followed him. Jesus went throughout Galilee, teaching in their synagogues and proclaiming the good news of the kingdom and curing every disease and every sickness among the people. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ.
We can all probably recall those times when, as children, we would be standing in the playground whilst two more senior children would be picking the teams. I wonder if you were one of those who was always picked first. Or perhaps you were lower down in the picking order, perhaps even left to that rather soul-destroying position, the last person chosen. Today's gospel reading includes an element of being chosen, but this story has a much more interesting emphasis. Earlier in Matthew's gospels, we can read of Jesus' baptism by John the Baptist. There it was John preaching to the people, telling them to repent, for the kingdom of heaven had come near. Now, following John's arrest, we read of Jesus using the exact same words as he now begins his ministry of proclamation. The stage, though, has moved from the river to the lake, from the River Jordan to the Lake of Galilee. Matthew makes the next phase follow on seamlessly, but I then do wonder if it was as straightforward as all that. Had Jesus had prior conversations with these two brothers? Elsewhere in the Gospels, we read that Andrew had been a disciple of John the Baptist and that he'd introduced his brother Peter to Jesus. So then, as Jesus walks along the lake shore, he sees these two brothers casting a net into the water, and he calls them with both an injunction and a promise. He says, "Follow me, and I will make you fish for people." It doesn't stop there, though. He next sees two other brothers, James and John. These two were in the boat, mending their nets, along with their father, when Jesus calls to them. And like Peter and Andrew, they leave the boat to follow Jesus. I wonder then, what was it that made them respond? What was it that impelled them to leave their family business and to follow a wandering preacher? What was it that drew them to a future which was clearly uncertain? Undeniably, as we read further in the Gospels, Jesus definitely had a strong personality. He had a magnetism and a charisma. But there was clearly something much deeper. We have here God's own call made to those four disciples. A call to follow. A call to live a life which is one of honesty, integrity, faith, hope, and also of love. A call to make that way of life a way of life that is only possible through Jesus. A call to make it relevant and available to others. Over the Christmas period, some of us might have watched the film Chariots of Fire. Many will know the synopsis of that film, which won several Oscars. For in the film, we share, amongst other things, the story of two wonderful athletes, Harold Abraham and Eric Liddell. And yes, the film plays around a little with the sequences for dramatic effect, but it does faithfully record Eric's understanding of his call to share his commitment to Jesus, both through his athleticism and then also in turn, which he honours that promise to his saviour to go to the mission field in China. And it was there that he died during the Second World War. Jesus's call to us is as strong today as it was for Eric Liddell, as it was for those first disciples on the side of the lake in Galilee. It is indeed a call to all of us to follow and to bring others closer to Jesus. Amen. So now let us make our profession of faith as we say together the words of the Creed. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic, and Apostolic Church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And so let us pray. And in silence, may we bring our own cares and concerns to God in prayer. Lord Jesus, who call people from their daily work, may we hear your voice and answer your call to give our lives to you, to serve your world and your church, to offer our gifts and to give our hearts to you alone. Amen. Our Saviour Christ is the Prince of Peace. Of the increase of his government and of peace there shall be no end. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
and also with you.
And so share Christ's peace with those around you, or if there is nobody there at the time, just think of someone with whom to share Christ's peace. And so our next hymn is All for Jesus. Blessed be God, by whose grace creation is renewed, by whose love heaven is opened, by whose mercy we offer our sacrifice of praise. Blessed be God forever. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
All honour and praise be yours always and everywhere, mighty Creator, ever-living God, through Jesus Christ, your only Son, our Lord. For at this time we celebrate your glory made present in our midst. In the coming of the Magi, the King of all the world was revealed to the nations. In the waters of baptism, Jesus was revealed as the Christ, the Saviour sent to redeem us. In the water made wine, the new creation was revealed at the wedding feast. Poverty was turned to riches, sorrow into joy. Therefore, with all the angels of heaven, we lift our voices to proclaim the glory of your name and sing our joyful hymn of praise.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory.
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Accept our praises, Heavenly Father, through your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. And as we follow his example and obey his command, grant that, by the power of your Holy Spirit, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us his body and his blood. Who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Therefore, Heavenly Father, we remember his offering of himself, made once for all upon the cross. We proclaim his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension. We look for the coming of your kingdom. And with this bread and this cup, we make the memorial of Christ, your Son, our Lord. Jesus Christ is Lord.
Lord, by your cross and resurrection, you have set us free. You are the Saviour of the world.
Accept through him, our great High Priest, this our sacrifice of thanks and praise. And as we eat and drink these holy gifts in the presence of your divine majesty, renew us by your Spirit, inspire us with your love, unite us in the body of your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, we worship you, Father Almighty, in songs of everlasting praise.
Blessing and honour and glory and power be yours forever and ever. Amen.
Let us pray for the coming of the kingdom in the words that Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break the bread of life, and that life is the light of the world. God here among us, God in the midst of us, bring us to light and life. God's holy gifts for God's holy people. Jesus Christ is holy. Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
Loving me grows slack from my
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we thank you for all the benefits you have won for us, for all the pains and insults you have borne for us. Most merciful Redeemer, friend and brother, may we know you more clearly, love you more dearly, and follow you more nearly, day by day. Amen. Our final hymn this morning is, Will You Come and Follow Me If I But Call Your Name?
Will you come and follow me if I but call your name? Will you go where you don't know and never be the same? Will you let my love be shown? Will you let my name be known? Will you let my life be grown in you?
And you in me.
Christ, the Son of God, perfect in you the image of his glory, and gladden your hearts with the good news of his kingdom. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you and those whom you love, now and always. Amen. Go in the light and peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.